Hello everyone! In this video I'm going to be showing you how I created my website with Wix. First off, I want to say thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video. It helps out my channel a lot. Even though Wix is sponsoring this video, all thoughts and opinions are my own. I recommend anyone trying to build their own business or internet following or online platform to have their own website. It gives a central spot where people can learn about you and what you do. When it comes to making my own website, I've always used Wix. This is my current website that I made a little over a year ago. When I made it, I remember being amazed at the results, mostly because I know nothing about coding or creating a website. But even with my limited knowledge, I was able to get a professional result. I wanted to revamp my website for a while now, so that's what we're going to be doing in this video. I'm going to be starting from scratch because I figured that'd be easier than trying to modify my current website. So I'm going to start by clicking the Create New Site button, and then Wix asks me what kind of site I want to create. I wanted a website to show off my illustrations, so I clicked on Photography. And oh my word, there are so many templates. My first site I created, I didn't use a template and I kind of didn't know what I was doing. So this time I want to use a template. I found the art and illustration section and saw the poster store template. I really liked the look of this one, so I clicked the blue edit button to start making it my own. So we're going to start by making this homepage my own. So I start by removing the picture on the left and replace it with my own by going to Add, Image, and then My Image Uploads. I then click Upload Media, Upload for my computer, and then load in my illustration for myself. I then drag the picture where I want it to be. That's the nice thing about Wix is that you can drag things around to where you want them to be. I wanted the background to be the same as the right side, so I click on the left column and then change column background. I then select the light teal color. One nifty feature is that you can create a color scheme for your site. I really liked the light peachy orange color, but I wanted it to be pink instead. So I click this circle button down here and then change this color to pink. Now all of the things that were orange are now pink. I didn't click the done button, so my color change wasn't saved. I fixed that later. So now let's take a look at the header. I changed this text to say my online username. I also decided to change the text style to one that easily read my username. I'm very indecisive, so this took me a while. Next, I changed this text right here to my own. I also drag things around a little bit. I really love how Wix has these little line rulers that pop up to help you center things and line things up. Now this page is starting to look more like my own. Yay! Until we scroll down a little. I'm going to erase everything I don't need. And then adjust the page height by dragging the bottom of the page up. I was going to further edit the page, but got distracted with the newsletter. It's really cool that Wix lets you set up your own newsletter. It's one of the features I'm really excited about because it gives another way for me to get information to my followers. I'm currently setting up the thank you message that I sent when a person signs up for my newsletter. I did all of this in a matter of just a few minutes, and I am pleased with the results. Next, I set up the social bar. The social bar is an easy way for visitors to know what social media platforms I am on. I just select the icons that match the websites I am on, and then paste in the links for those websites. Lastly, for the footer, I changed the copyright information. Because this is my homepage, I kind of wanted to give an overview about myself and what's on my site. So to start, I'm going to make a little section to promote my art by adding a picture I created. I then add a hover box by going to Add, Box, and then Hover Box. I think these are cool because when you hover your mouse cursor over them, they change to the different text. I edited the text and the look of the box to make it my own. I wanted to add a button under the box that links to my gallery. So I add a button that says Gallery on it. And then I go to the site menu to add a gallery page. Then I go back to the button and make it so that when it is clicked, it will take the user to the gallery. I also want to promote my YouTube channel, so I'm going to add one of my videos. I go to Add, Video, Single Video Players, and then add the YouTube one. I then search for one of my videos to add. Like with the art section, I add one of those nifty hover boxes. I really like working with Wix because I don't need to know any coding to make my own website. Before finding Wix, I felt like it was nearly impossible for me to get my own website, but it's actually pretty simple. That's all I'm going to add to the homepage for now, so let's take a look at some of the other pages. For the gallery, I wanted to show off my art. I set up this area for my finished illustrations. I also want a sketchbook area, so I'll show you how I set that up. I go to Add, Gallery, and then Galleries. I then click on the one I want to add to the page. I make it the size that I want it to be, and then click Manage Media. I want to add my own picture, so I click Add Media and Upload from Computer. After finding the pictures I want, I click Add to Page. And ta-da! My gallery's done in a matter of minutes. For the About page, nothing very interesting happens. I just remove the stuff I don't want and then add some text about myself. Also, I did edit the shop page and I actually set up my own online shop, which I'm really excited about. I'm not going to go over that in this video because it's a lot of information that I would need to talk about. It could be its own video. But setting up my own online shop didn't take very long and I am very pleased with the result. I decided I wanted to add a drop-down menu for more pages that aren't as important as the main pages. So I go to the site menu, click Add Folder, and then name it More. I then drag the character page under the More folder, right-click it, and then select Make Subpage. So now when I scroll over the More text, I see the other pages. This helps the header not get too crowded. For the contact page, I simplified it. I took away most of the info and changed the background. Now visitors have an easy way to contact me. Lastly, we have the My Characters page. I thought it would be nice to have a page about my original characters. So I added pictures like I did before and added a little bit of text about them. What's also cool with Wix is that you get a mobile version of your site. You can view it by clicking this button. Wix can convert your desktop site into a mobile site. It can take a little bit of editing sometimes. I did have to make a few changes to the homepage, but overall it was a smooth process. Okay, so let's take a look at my finished website. Also, I did make little tweaks to this website while not recording. I kind of would hop on for a few minutes and then make a few edits here and there, but I would forget to record, so I apologize for that. But I didn't make any major changes, just kind of cosmetic ones. I really recommend Wix if you are looking to create your own website. Even someone like me who knows nothing about website creation is able to make a professional looking site. If you want to start building your own site for free, you can go to wix.com/go/love-to-draw-manga. The link is in the description. Also, if you want to check out my finished website, I have the link to it in the description. I would be honored if you went and had a look at it. So that is all for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much again to Wix for sponsoring this video. And I'll see you all on Saturday for my usual weekly video. Bye!